challenge each and every one of you to take up the challenge of Mission 180. Let's pray. Father, tonight I just want to lift up these students to you. I just want to pray as they take this challenge of Mission 180 that you would give them the strength, the perseverance, the courage to be able to do that.
Who are you? What do you want? Speak up. That's what I thought.
Yes, sir. We've got him.
Are you afraid, Josh?
Yeah.
Good. It's good to be on the alert.
Who are you guys anyway?
Well, I sent for you. We sent for you.
But how do you know my name?
You're wearing a name tag. Josh, we are the Nihilists. We are agents of the Most High God. My name is Agent Omega, and we have just rescued you from the Zorks. Those little rascals. It's like he's always taunting me. Anyway, our mission is to defeat the Zorks before they conquer us. And we have to have a real good understanding that our enemies are very cunning, and so we must be prepared.
But why am I here? What does all this have to do with me?
Everything. And I'll explain all that to you in due time. Oh, by the way, let me introduce you to our teammates. This is Cow and Lamb Chop. Josh, here's your weapon. You cannot, I repeat, you cannot go into battle without this. Now, Nihilix, before we do anything, we must make sure that we're prepared. And the best way that we can make sure we're prepared before we enter battle is to go to the Lord in prayer. So let's pray. God, we know how the story ends. We know you're in control. But help us to move forward with confidence and without fear. God, you said that you will give us every place where we set our feet, just as you promised your servant Moses long ago. We claim that promise today. Give us strength and courage. We pray this in your name. Amen. All right, guys, our first mission is to spy out the enemy territory. So what we need to do is I need Josh and Cal. I need you to go out and see exactly what we're up against. Lamb Chop and myself will stay here and we'll provide support from home base. I need you to be back in 24 hours to give me a full report of exactly what we're up against. Josh, Cal, are you prepared?
What happened?
What happened? Why do you not return with Nihilix? Speak up!
Ah, so he's trying again. Omega. With a kid. What does he think he can do with a kid? What have I got to be worried about? He's probably cowering in some corner somewhere.
Okay, Josh. I'm gonna head over there. And when I give you the signal, you come in behind me.
Okay.
You heard what the boss said. If you see any intruders, you know what to do with them.
Well, at least I've got my...
Cow.
What? What?
I forgot my sword.
Luckily, I brought this. Hold your ears.
Josh, I know it's exciting when you're out there on the field, but the execution of the actual mission is not the most important thing. There's other things that are just as important, like being prepared. That's the most important thing. I mean, you saw what happened when you got out there and you were with the enemy. We have to be prepared. And you have to be prepared every time, mentally, physically, spiritually. It's important. Next time,
I'll be prepared.
Okay. Well, guys, let's be back here at 0900 hours.
I feel like I failed you guys. Like, I failed all the Nylex. It was because of me we had to bail.
Don't sweat it, man. Sure, you weren't prepared at the time, but you learned a valuable lesson. Always be prepared. Just like Omega's been saying, being prepared is half the battle, and it's just as important to bring your weapon to the battle as it is to know how to use it.
I guess you're right.
Yell.
That's it?
Get pretty close.
I heard you already.
Guys, be quiet.
Get pretty close.
Stop.
What part about spying do you not understand?
The spying part.
Alright guys, let's go.
So we're just gonna yell?
Yep.
It seemed a little weird, don't you think?
Remember what happened last time when we didn't follow orders?
But yell?
Omega, do you read me?
Loud and clear.
Josh, are you there?
Yes, sir.
Okay, Josh. Now listen to me. You remember how we talked about you need to be prepared?
Yeah.
Well, there's one more step.
And that's obedience. Josh, I know you won't understand why I'm asking you to do this, but you must obey what I say. Otherwise, the mission will fail. You have one shot. One shot.
Are you ready?
Yeah.
Cal?
I need you to show Josh where the Zorg entrance is.
The what?
Roger that.
And what exactly am I going to be doing?
You're going to walk towards the gate, shout in God's name, and then continue into their headquarters, and then you'll be guided from there to complete the final mission alone.
Oh yeah, I'm just going to waltz in there, ask the good Zorg, hey, you going to help me finish this mission? Yeah, give me the last piece of the puzzle.
Seriously?
Josh, you must be committed to this 100%. Are you prepared to enter the battlefield?
But I don't even understand. I forgot my...
It's because of me we had to bail.
Yes.
Josh, you've got to follow through. You must walk through that gate. It's the only way to complete the final mission.
But what is it? Why should I take such a huge risk for something that's most likely gonna fail?
You must trust me. Shout with all your might.
Omega, I'm losing you.
You have everything you need. If God is for you, who could be against you?
Omega!
Obey, Josh. Obey.
Why am I here? I can't do this.
You're not going to make it. You're weak. You're too weak. You're only one person. What can you do?
I've got to go. I have to do this. I've got to trust what Omega said. All right. Here we go.
Josh, you can't make it.
Here you go, I'll walk through the valley of the shadow of death.
You think your God can save you now? Where is he now?
Fear no evil.
No, you can't make it.
Because you aren't with me.
No!
No one will be able to stand up against you all the days of your life.
No.
As I was with Moses, so I will be with you. Never will I leave you nor forsake you!
I'm not finished with you yet! You have not won! You have not...
I thought Omega said that I...
That somebody would be there to help guide you to complete the mission?
Omega! I don't understand. I thought this was supposed to be the Zork headquarters. I mean,
Josh.
I obeyed all your commands and miraculously made it through the gate.
Josh.
And I shouted as loud as I could! They all disappeared. Only after a step of faith.
Josh!
And then they all disappeared
Josh.
And...
Josh!
Yeah?
The Zorgs, they aren't real.
What?
When we were back at headquarters, I noticed that you had rummaged through all of my folders, and one of them talked about Mission 180.
Yeah,
about that.
Well, think about it. Hasn't your preacher been talking to you about witnessing to your lost friends?
Yeah, I can never do that. All my friends at school would think I'm weird and stuff.
Well... What else has your preacher been talking to you about lately?
He said something about our schools being our greatest mission field and we need to witness. I could never do that. He also said that we have 180 days to be a witness at our schools.
See, that's exactly what Mission 180 is. It's the idea of going into your school for 180 days and doing whatever it takes to witness to your lost friends.
But Omega, I could never do that. My preacher said that we need to be prepared to witness to my lost friends and to obey God even though we might not know why we're doing it and something about remembrance, like what the Israelites did. I could never do that. To be honest, I'm scared out of my mind to be that bold at my school.
But see, that's the thing. You can do it. Think about what you've just done. You took on a whole horde of Zorks, and you defeated them. And you took that first step of obedience and in faith. I mean, I don't know if you realize, but the Zorks, that they're all of your fears, all of your concerns, all of your doubts about witnessing to your lost friends. And as you notice, as you took that challenge on, they all just began to fade away. And that's what Mission 180 is. And don't you see that you accomplished all of that through the power of God? You learned to be prepared. You learned to be obedient. And God can use you to accomplish Mission 180. Are you ready for that?
I am.
And something important you need to remember is that in the Old Testament, when the Israelites crossed the Jordan River, when God parted the waters for them, they took 12 stones out and they piled them up as a way to commemorate and remember what God had done. And I challenge you to remember. Remember this moment. Remember what God has done. Josh, are you ready? Are you ready for Mission 180?
I'm ready.
In your son's name that we pray.